A blessed morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. We are now on the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Today is also the St. Peter the Apostle Sunday. The Pontifical Mission Societies of the Philippines leads us in the observance of the pontifical work of St. Peter the Apostle. Dear brothers and sisters, God did not make death, nor does He rejoice in the destruction of the living. The Book of Wisdom proclaims God as Lord of life, and in the Gospel, Jesus confirms that God does not intend men and women for corruption. Sent by God to conquer death, Jesus heals a woman long afflicted with hemorrhage and brings Jairus' daughter back to life. In the face of trial and adversity, may we have the daring faith of Jairus and of the woman, confident in Jesus' power. Let us now rise and welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of His minister, Reverend Father Julius Habana.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Together we say, I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned. In my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Yeah.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. God wills life, not death. By the envy of the devil, death entered the world, but this would be undone by faith in Jesus. The first reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. God did not make death, nor does he rejoice in the destruction of the living. For he fashioned all things that might have being, and the creatures of the world are wholesome. And there is not a destructive drug among them, nor any domain of the netherworld on earth, for justice is undying. For God formed man to be imperishable, the image of his own nature he had made him. But by the envy of the devil, death entered the world, and they who belong to his company experience it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Paul appeals to the Corinthians that since God in Christ has been generous with his gift of life, so they too must share the resources with their needy brothers and sisters. The second reading.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Sisters and brothers, as you excel in every respect, in faith, discourse, knowledge, all earnestness, and in the love we have for you, may you excel in this gracious act also. For you know the gracious act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, for your sake he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. Not that others should have relief while you are burdened, but that as a matter of equality, your abundance all the present time should supply their needs, so that their abundance may also supply your needs, that there may be equality. As it is written, whoever had much did not have more, and whoever had little did not have less. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
Our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed death and brought life to light through the Gospel.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a large crowd gathered around him and he stayed close to the sea. One of the synagogue officials named Jairus came forward. Seeing him, he fell at his feet and pleaded earnestly with him, saying, "My daughter is at the point of death. Please come to lay your hands on her, that she may get well and live." He went off with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed upon him. There was a woman afflicted with hemorrhages for 12 years. She had suffered greatly at the hands of many doctors and had spent all that she had. Yet, she was not helped, but only grew worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. She said, "If I but touch his clothes, I shall be cured." Immediately, her flow of blood dried up. She felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. Jesus, aware at once that power had gone out from him, turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who has touched my clothes?" But his disciples said to Jesus, "You see how the crowd is pressing upon you, and yet you ask, 'Who touched me?'" And he looked around to see who had done it. The woman, realizing what had happened to her, approached in fear and trembling. She fell down before Jesus and told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has saved you. Go in peace and be cured of your affliction." While he was still speaking, people from the synagogue official's house arrived and said, "Your daughter has died. Why trouble the teacher any longer?" Disregarding the message that was reported, Jesus said to the synagogue official, "Do not be afraid. Just have faith." He did not allow anyone to accompany him inside except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they arrived at the house of the synagogue official, he caught sight of a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. So he went in and said to them, "Why this commotion and weeping? The child is not dead, but asleep." And they ridiculed him. Then he put them all out. He took along the child's father and mother and those who were with him and entered the room where the child was. He took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talita kum," which means, "Little girl, I say to you, arise." The girl, a child of 12, arose immediately and walked around. At that, they were utterly astounded. He gave strict orders that no one should know this and said that he should be given something to eat. My brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Good morning. We are now on the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And our readings today reveal us the heart of the Lord God. That is, He's always merciful and loving. And we are all invited to respond in faith. Perhaps if we try to enter into the story of the gospel, perhaps we can appreciate better what's happening, especially in the first part of the gospel, wherein Jairus, a synagogue official, approached Jesus, fell to his knees, and begged him, "My daughter is at the point of death. Please come, lay your hands on her, that she may get well and live." Imagine a synagogue official kneeling before this Jesus asking for help. During the time of Jesus, this is actually unimaginable. He has position. He is above many people. By kneeling before Jesus, he is actually stripping off his position. He's actually trying to forget his position. He's even trying to forget himself. He's trying to forget even his friends. Ano yan ihambal sa mga abyan niya, sa iya? Ay, nagluhod-luhod ka lang doon sa manugbulong. But this story is also telling us that this synagogue official
had forgotten himself, his position, and even his friends. For what reason? Just to ask Jesus to cure his dying daughter. Perhaps we have also stories like this. Nablang daw wala ka na sang kantuan, ginimo mo na ang tanan. And yet there is this somebody introduced to you, perhaps by friends, colleagues, kaganigin kantuan mo, kay desperado na kita, kag magpangayo sang bulig. In the second part of the gospel, about the story of this woman suffering from bleeding for 12 years, she approached Jesus. Ining damo-damo pagin sa nagakalatabo diri sa istorya sining babayi nga ginadugo. Ngaa. In the Jewish tradition, if you are bleeding, you will be considered unclean. So nobody can touch you, or else they will also be considered unclean. In other words, you have to isolate yourself because you are unclean. Imagine also the risk of approaching Jesus given the great crowd following him. Pero, dispirada man siya. He spent all her fortune. And yet, wala man sa nag-ayuhan. Naglala pa. Hindi ka naman dispirada. She gathered all her strength and courage just to approach Jesus. Silinga gani, even just the tassel. Siya nila lang sa sid-sid sa iyabayo. Okay na ko. Imagine mo kung ano ka desperada. But at times, how do we look at desperate people? Na wala bili. But that's precisely how she put herself in that situation. Desperada gid niya. But at times, this is also our experience. Nahuya lang kita akoon, pero sa madamo at yun, naging desperado man kita. We have done our part. Perhaps we have approached many friends. Yet, look at our situation. Daw amo man ta sa gihapon. Perhaps we've been also into that desperate situation that also tested our faith. Pero anong natabo? Sige lang. Kay kapatigid ko, bisan last na lang ni. Ang importante, may kapyutan pa ko subong. I still have hope. And I wanna hold on to this. And so, she touched the tassel of the cloak of Jesus. And she was dried up. nauntat ang bleeding. Jesus, feeling and realizing that power has gone out of him, ask, "Who touched me?" But imagine that even our desperate situation can let loose God's power. Pero nami lang sa Diyos, sa sininga gospel kay ginpabay-an niya ang sitwasyon sang babayi nga magpalapit kag magtandog sa iya. Kun sa aton guro sitwasyon nablang abyanta would only approach us and consider us as last recourse. Nablang baw kay wain na sa mapiminsaran nga iban, ako na lang daw ikaw ya ang last nga nadumduman niya sang kinahanglan niya ang buli. Pero kung bugalon guro si Jesus, wala ito ginpasugtan. Sige, baw, mayo ka lang magpalapit sa akon kung madumduman mo ko ba? Diba? Daw mo matanong kisa, we only approach God in prayer when we are in need or perhaps when we are desperate. But in our happy moments, we would forget God. Is that actually included in our decisions? But if all things fail, we remember Him. Pero wala ya pride, wala bugal kay Jesus. He allowed His power to go out and heal that woman. God has given us much. He has showed us His mercy and compassion. Of course, at times we remember Him only in dire need, when we are desperate. But God would continue to love us and to show us His mercy. And that is why the invitation for us is to have faith. Just like the faith expressed by Jairus in our gospel when he fell into his knees and begged Jesus for help. The same faith expressed by this woman suffering from hemorrhages for 12 years already, when she gathered all her strength and approached Jesus. Just to have faith, believing that God is the one whom we can lean on, especially in dire need, even in those desperate moments. Kita tungod kay we've been going to church at least every Sunday, perhaps we have already deepened our faith in God. But at times we are also challenged to deepen our faith in God. At times, we even question our faith, saying to ourselves, I go to Mass at Carmel every Sunday, but why is it as if God is not done with me yet in giving me all these difficulties and trials in life? I've been donating my fortune to Carmel and to other charitable institutions. Pero nga daw, damo mo kong yapon problema. I've tried to be good, to be holy, but why is it nga daw kadamo sa gihapon sang palaligban kag problema? At times we question even the faith that we have. Pero sige lang. Kay ang Diyos ya, batunon lang man na, bisan ang mga pamasulta. But know always, we are being reminded by our first reading that God did not make death, nor does He rejoice in the destruction of the living. Know always that we can approach Him. Know always that we have a God who is willing to reach out to us and allow His power to go out just to heal us. Imagine this gesture of Jesus willing to go with Jairus into his home just to heal his daughter. That's also how the Lord God is to us. Kadtuan niya gid kita kag ayuhon. At times, we thought to ourselves that we are the one approaching God. Pero sa tutuod lang, ang Diyos ya ang mas una nga nagapalapit sa aton. That opportunity for Jairus to approach Jesus, that was actually the intention of Jesus all along. Why He wanted to cross the Sea of Galilee. Because there are actually many people waiting for Him, including the synagogue official named Jairus. This is the continuation of the gospel we heard last Sunday. That desire of Jesus to cross the Sea of Galilee, to reach out and to touch many people, desperate people, seeking for help, seeking for healing. And we would understand the great crowd gathered around Jesus. But that was His initiative, to go to them, to reach out to them in order to touch them, to heal them, to restore them to life. All the while, we thought that this is our initiative to go to Mass. This is perhaps our way of saying, O Lord, tagay ko grasya kay nagsimba ko ha. Ako gid bala nagbugtaw aga pa para nga makadto sa Carmel 6 a.m. para nga may pulungkuan pa ko. Lord, hatag mo gid sa akon ang ginapangayo ko ha. Naghatag ko bala chimpo, nagrisgo bala ko bala bisan may COVID. Hatag mo gid. All the while we thought this is our initiative to wake up early, to go to Mass, to praise God. But truth is, this is actually God's initiative. Tabi natun, sa atun pagsimba, mas may ginahatag kita sa Diyos. But this is actually an invitation for us to receive God's many blessings and graces. Again, if we only respond in faith, just like by waking up early this morning to attend this Eucharistic celebration, only because God has blessed us already. That's because God has graced us already with this life to wake up early this morning and so praise Him. Kung kisa nagakalipat lagid kita bisang antis because we focus too much on our need. Just like the woman, perhaps she focused only on her need. Just like Jairus, he focused only on her need to restore the health of his daughter. Sa tutuod lang, inisyatibo to sang Diyos. We realize that God always takes the initiative to approach us. And may, like Jairus and the woman in our gospel, may we always respond in faith. We continue with this holy sacrifice of the Mass, grateful to the Lord for all the blessings He has given us. And by appreciating all the blessings that we receive from the Lord, may we always respond in faith and deepen our faith. Amen. We shall now all rise and profess our faith. Together we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray to the Heavenly Father that we may receive healing in mind, body, and soul, and become instruments of healing to one another. In every petition, let our response be, Lord of life, hear our prayer.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
May the Church, the people of God, continue Christ's healing work by caring for all those who are sick, depressed, the abandoned, and the elderly. We pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
May doctors and nurses, social workers, and all those who care for the sick, the suffering, the poor, and the oppressed do their job with patience, skill, and mercy, we pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
May all who mourn the passing of their loved ones be comforted by their faith in the risen Lord who has brought us life that can never be taken away, we pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer. In a special way, we also remember in our prayers those people who are in need of our prayers, especially at this time. We pray,
Lord of life,
hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, listen to our humble petitions. Help us to have more faith in Jesus' healing power, your love for us and for all humanity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please always.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricia, our Bishop, Vicente, our Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Queen of Peace, dear Lady of Mount Carmel, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, San Pedro Calungsod, San Sebastian, San Antonio de Padua, Saint John Mervenay, Saint Margaret Mary Alacoc, Saint Padre Pio, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint John of the Cross, Saint Therese, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we now dare say,
"Thy kingdom come.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ.
Amen. Amen. Please all rise.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice you have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We shall now pray the mission prayer. God, our loving Father, you sent your Son into the world to proclaim the good news of salvation to all, to sinners, the poor, oppressed, the sick, the abandoned and neglected. He gave his life on the cross for us, arose again to new life, to redeem us and reconcile us with you. You sent your Holy Spirit to the apostles to continue the work of your Son and to lead all to salvation. We thank you, Father, for bringing us from darkness into light. Through your loving plan 500 years ago, missionaries came to our land to proclaim the gospel of Jesus, your Son, to our ancestors that made us your people and the church. The gift of faith has accompanied us through both darkness and lights, defeats and victories of our history as your people. Our faith has become for us true light that shines in the darkness. Renew in us the grace of your Spirit that impels us to be witnesses of Jesus your Son to a world broken by greed, violence, injustice, sickness, and suffering. May our faith bring us to unity as your children, to care for and love one another. May the Holy Spirit empower us to be proclaimers of the good news to our brothers and sisters in Asia and to all nations. Give us a sincere desire to help others to come to faith in the Lord Jesus, to share in your joy and life. May the Blessed Mother, the star of evangelization, accompany us and pray for us as we live and share our faith with others. May our strong love and devotion to her as our Mahal na Ina form us to be true disciples and witnesses of Jesus to all, always ready to be sent and to be obedient to whatever Jesus asks of us. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now that love has found us, go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.